Yo, I'm just imagining a damn share because too much, my UPM, I also stop bragging, and you already know this is KECHE, catch share, the scooting president, yeah, Kasa TV, yo, I watch you every day, tune in, let's go, peace.
Yes, welcome to Yekasa TV. My name is Jibril, as you know. Every day I get you exclusive content. I speak to celebrities. Note, it is not only celebrities. Whenever you have the talent, whatever you are doing that has to do with creative arts, this is a platform where we come, we discuss, we put it out there. People watch and they know what is happening. I'm here with Peter Richie, big man in the Ghana movie industry. I've been following him since, I think 2016. We became friends, but a dog in me, but any issue. Today, I caught up with him here at a colleague's lunch of his fashion school and then a collection as well. And so, we want to have industry talks. Peter, may that say,
Charlie.
It's been a while.
COVID, you're looking good. COVID, into. So, well, you know, this year, dear. What do you want to this year after all the year? Definitely.
Are you American?
David, me a Voterican.
Voterican!
Thank you.
I was like, Voterican, number 9. Bro, how is life treating
you?
I'm not sure. You know, Ghana prayer, I see the Ghana film prayer tour, they were going to Takrade, Kumasi to do, have you heard of it?
Ghana film prayer tour.
I think it's...
As in prayer.
Prayer,
and
yes.
And player.
Prayer. I'm a bumpire. I think, really? Yes, a lot of your guys, a lot of your filmmakers were
as in my colleagues.
Your colleagues.
Okay.
You see the Christiana Wuni, the Apostle John Pra. This is a Honorable Bela Samoa, Richard Boate.
Okay.
These are the.
There's a Americans, no doors.
Ken Fiati.
Whichever way it is, prayer is needed. Yeah. So it must not necessarily come from a particular group of people. I mean, if they have sat down and to think that this is the way forward, why not? I mean, it's a support that we would all give. But seriously, I have not heard about it. But whatever it is, since it is a prayer, and it is a prayer to our Maker, and they believe in it that prayer answereth all things, why not?
But that if they are going to pray and revive, I know yes. You can be successful, but you still need prayer to keep you going.
Definitely.
But in this state, they are saying that the movie industry is dead, and that is why they are praying to revive it. Is it
for me, I don't want to believe the assertion that the movie industry is dead. It is not dead. I've said this, and I'm going to say it again. Every industry gets to that point that it goes through challenges, except you are not a business person. But if you're a business person, whilst you're thinking about the growth of the business, at the same time you have to be thinking about the possibility that there can be that downside of
that's
it,
yeah.
Of it.
Yeah.
So whilst you're planning, you plan for both sides. But I mean, Obiabe can say, whilst you are planning, you plan for the positivities more than the negativity. But it doesn't also take away the fact that the negativities can set in. So I believe that where we are right now, it's a challenging time as an industry. We are going through that phase that we need to rise up. It's actually teaching us a lot to say that, hey, apparently before we thought all is well, but maybe for us not to take certain things into consideration, you know, and then idea do baby, I always say, so then it's rather a time for us to rise up and to rather put structures in place and to see the growth of the industry to another pedestal rather than what it is today.
You're talking about putting structures in place. I'm sure at the moment the MPP is the current government leading the whole nation. I'm sure you've seen their manifesto for the creative arts, have you?
I've not seen it, but I've heard about it. I've even heard one of my senior, let me say, colleagues in the industry talked about it on Joy FM. I think it was even a whole show that is on the A to Z program on Saturday. A to Z program on Saturday. It was a whole show that was actually dedicated for the discussion of this thing. I mean, it's a good thing. I mean, it's something we've been praying for, something that we all looking forward for, that any government that comes into power would try to do something for the creative art or the creative industry. Let's just say that, let's cast ourselves back to, like, let's say 5 years,
yes, back, yeah.
5 years back. Yeah. If every, or let me not use 5 years, let's just say 12 years, because 4 years, 4 years,
okay.
4 years,
okay,
4 years.
So
for all the political parties. Yeah. If every party that comes into power tries to do something for the creative industry, for this 12 years, I don't think we should be talking like this or to be at where we are right now, okay? So I would say that yes, some have tried to do something, some too are stepping up, and some too have really, really taken it upon their shoulders to even do it more better and bigger. So if the MPP government is looking into that direction, I would say it's a good thing. It's a good thing. It is just my prayer that if God willing, they end up into office again, like if they should go for another term, my prayer is that they continue with the good thing that they started with the industry.
Okay. So, in this sense, you agree with Marco Kwekumante, Sokwe Safu, claiming that they want the MPP to remain in power and be able to continue what they've
done. You see, for that aspect, meet me Kase. We are human beings and everybody definitely belongs to one party or the other. That we can't take it away.
Okay,
we can't take it away. So if Marco Krefu and Sokwe Safu Dems are saying that MPP should remain in office, then it means that they have seen something that maybe I have not seen yet. Or maybe my other colleagues have not seen yet. That is why they are saying that. But the bottom line for me is that if what the MPP government is doing for the creative industry is in the right direction and is going to bring the industry up to the point that we feel that, okay, even if they are not able to do it all, but they've put in us somewhere, and we know that we are climbing gradually, it is better than not doing anything at all.
Okay.
Let's even say here that should, let's say, MPP not to even win, and NDC should win, or whichever party wins and comes into office. MPP have started something for the creative arts. So it is just better that whichever party that comes into power
should continue
from that level. But let's say that if MPP wins, let's not forget this, that the vision bearer knows best what is embedded in his or her vision. So if MPP should win again, obviously, let me say, they started with it. So they know what and what to put into it to make it more better.
Right. I get you. But it's unfortunate, eh?
Yeah.
Even after the whole thing came, the whole manifesto came, we had a short snippet of the NDC, which is John Dramani Mahama, also claiming a different thing altogether, not an alignment. So don't you think that with the likes of Mark and then, aren't they making a point? Because, you know, these are two political parties. They all have different agendas.
Different agendas, right,
and then,
definitely,
if Mahama comes or the NDC comes,
obviously,
if you look at what President Mahama is coming in with, he's talking about vamping NAFTA into a multimedia university and that kind of thing. It's totally different from what the MPP brought.
You see, for me, where I stand as an individual, Peter Ricci, whatever plans either of them have is a good plan. But me, my take is, put the agenda right so that when either MPP comes into office, they follow it. When NDC comes into office, they follow it. You see, you see, oh yeah, they now what's starting to say now, Obi Bano, the Bibia Toso. The thing goes up. Obi Soba, no, sorry, Bibia Toso. Then it goes, it keeps increasing rather than Obi Ba. Now, let's scrub it off. All that the first person has started with trying to do his or her own thing now. Maybe with time, no, so maybe I'll not so into me, we no no so if you are, then another person comes. Yeah, yeah. So for me, Ninano, it boils down to Sikasaye.
Yeah.
And it goes down to
even retrogressing the whole
process.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it goes down to affect the taxpayer. Yeah, yeah. So let's just have a national agenda for everything that we are doing. For everything that we're doing, so that whether I, Peter Richie, comes into power as president, I know that this is the national agenda. Whether you, Jibril, you come into power, you know that this is the national agenda. But bottom line to all that I am saying, MPP have started a good thing. To me, it's a very good thing for the industry. I'm not trying to say that, in quote, NDC is bad. Yeah, no, that's not what I'm saying. We've been fighting for this thing to happen. We've been fighting for the industry to grow. So if a party has come into power and have started a course for this same growth that we've been fighting for, I mean, we should just look at the positive aspect of it and push it well.
Peter, let's feel free, eh? Let's just, I think this whole industry,
that's the truth.
Peter, I know you've won awards. Mami General, like, how many awards you?
To be frank with you, I could say, I mean, those that I can think about or remember right now can be like 3 or 4. And currently I've been nominated for another award. Which I'll be going in. I mean, act as personal actor, something.
That, yeah.
Yes.
Role model kind of.
Yes.
I want you to go somewhere, but let me first of all. Yeah. Do you miss the Ghana Movie Awards?
I'll say I miss it. I miss it so much, but if it is coming back, then it should come back better than what we know. Mm. That's all I'll say.
You miss it, but if it's coming back,
it should come out better. No, because it's an industry thing. Mm. We don't have it. Mm. To me, we don't have it. Mm. That's the truth. Yeah, I mean, you people can take me on, but I really, really do not care. We don't have it. Mm. We don't have movie awards.
And we don't sad. Have it. Is it sad?
It's sad. We don't have it. We don't have it.
Will you blame the organizers?
I don't want to blame anybody, but I think that people need to listen and to learn. In this world that we are, change is constant. Change is constant. And we need to every day learn and change whilst we are growing. If you refuse to change and if you refuse to learn, then it's like, it's better you are not existing.
Understandable. So, at long last, what would you want to say to those watching us and Ghanaians in general?
Ghanaians in general, I say this, your boy Peter Richie. Let's support the movie industry. Let's support the entertainment industry. Let's support any individual at all that want to bring in ideas, visions, plans, even money to make our industry a better one. Let's not forget God whilst we are climbing up there. Thank you very much.
Charlie, thank you very much. Stay tuned. I'll give you more exclusive content here on Yakasa TV. Subscribe to this channel by clicking the button. Thank you very much, Richie.
Thank you too, bro.
We'll vibe more. Sharp.